Hi there, guys, and welcome back to some more Undrafted MVP. It's a special episode. It's not because we're going to be continuing Tony Romo's story. Well, not playing, at least. We're going to be seeing if Tony Romo will make the Hall of Fame. We're going to be simulating through multiple seasons, probably at least another 10, and we will see how his stats go, whether he wins the Super Bowl, whether we stay at the Cowboys. In fact, I might make that decision. We're going to keep him at the Cowboys. But yeah, let's see how his career pans out. It'll be nice to see him win a Super Bowl after Jason Garrett lost us the chance of at least getting to a Super Bowl last season. If you want to know who won the Super Bowl in the end, it was the Chicago Bears. They beat the Baltimore Ravens 33-24 in the Super Bowl of 2020. Let us simulate to the beginning, the middle of the 2020 NFL season. Okay, so we are in week 9 of the 2020 NFL season. We're going to see, first of all, we're going to look at the standings. So at the moment, the Cowboys are 5-2, along with the Redskins. The Eagles are 4-4, Giants 2-5, but whatever. So stats-wise, this, well, it's certainly not as good as the year before. 1,700 passing yards after, is it 8 games? 7, 8 games? 7 games, so his numbers could still go up. 18 touchdowns to 4 picks. I mean, it's less interceptions at this time of the season, and way less touchdowns as well. Okay, so we're going to upgrade Tony Romo again. We're going to upgrade Scrambler a bit. Because I think if we increase his throw on the run, if we have a look at his ratings, I mean, throw on the run, 78. Play action, 88. Break sack, 76. Those will probably go up with Scrambler, so we're going to do that. Maybe his speed will as well. Well, all the ones I thought would go up did go up, so we'll just increase that again. Seems to be going up quite nicely. We're going to give it to Field General here, see what goes up. Two throw actually short, nice. He's now 99 overall quarterback in two different schemes. And then we'll go West Coast as well. There we go, throw actually short goes up again. So, an 89 overall scrambler quarterback. Considering he's got, well, those physical stats, it looks really promising. So, with that, we will advance to the playoffs and see whether the Cowboys make it. Okay, so we're officially at the playoffs. It doesn't look like... they've made it. They haven't. The Cowboys have finished 9-7. Don't even get in the wild card. Wow, let's have a look at the standings. We'll have a look at the NFC. Yep, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the Buccaneers make the playoffs over the Cowboys. There at 9-7. So the Cowboys miss out on the playoffs after being one game away from the Super Bowl. This feels like real life when the Cowboys just seem to go to shit once they've had a good season. But let's have a look at the stats. Tony Romo was not good this year. Well, I say not good. Wasn't as good as the season before, clearly. 3,411 yards off of 324 completions, 31 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. A much better year in terms of interceptions, but they needed those extra 21 touchdowns to propel them into the playoffs last year. Sacked just 21 times though this season, compared to 60 or whatever it was last season. Rushing, Ezekiel Elliott had over 2,000 rushing yards for the second year running and 15 touchdowns. Unbelievable. Receiving, nobody had over 1,000 yards receiving. Austin Hooper's the devil. So we won't be, we'll hopefully cut him in the off season. But the highest yards was Michael Thomas. Highest receptions, Allen Hurns. And most touchdowns was Allen Hurns, followed by Keelan Cole. So certainly interesting looking at the numbers when you don't play. So we'll upgrade Romo again, see what we can get him up to now. We're going to go West Coast. Get him up to 99 on this. He's going to be pretty unstoppable. Tony Romo is now a 99 overall quarterback in three different schemes, 91 in the other, despite being slow as hell. We're going to go to the off-season and see who won the Super Bowl. Okay, and the winner of the 2021 Super Bowl champions are the Chicago Bears for the second year in a row. That's going to be the new dynasty. Philip Soliday is the new Tom Brady, I guarantee it. He's going to be hard to beat. Tony Romo has already had his contract settled. 6 years, $143 million. And it looks like he's going to have quite a nice year in 2026. But yeah, that's that. Let's go to the middle of next season now. Okay, so we have come to the end of the 2021 NFL season. And the Cowboys have gone 15-1 again. It's looking promising, boys. They were 6-1 after seven games, 15-1 after the regular season finished. Let's look at the stats. Romo throws nearly 4,000 yards, throws another 39 touchdowns. So it's still a big season. Just five picks again this season. So he's way more accurate than last season as well. 71% this season. He's had, from the looks of things, an emphatic season. Rushing, Elliott, man, another 1,800 yard plus season and 12 touchdowns as well. Unbelievable. Receiving, Michael Thomas, over 1,000 yards this season. That's what we like to see. And 11 touchdowns. Big from him. We will also have a look at the end of year awards. And Tony Romo is MVP for the second time in his short career. So Garrett is still at the Cowboys, and we're going to upgrade Romo's scrambling abilities. His carrying is plus one. Why not speed? Why not throw power? This is what I want to see increased. Ooh. Plus one spin move, plus two trucking. What? Wow. What's he got this time? Plus one speed, yes! He's now up to 66 speed, it's unbelievable. If he could just have a plus seven speed one time, that'd be great. Whoa, okay. Well, there's still no plus one speed again. God damn it. Still no plus one speed. Okay, he's up to 96 overall for Scrambler. He's got Field General Strong Arm and West Coast already at 99. I mean, let's look at this. I mean, he is literally the best quarterback in the league at the moment. Let us see if, come Super Bowl Sunday, the Cowboys are still in contention. And the Cowboys have reached the Super Bowl. It is unbelievable. The Cowboys are there 2 years, I think. Yeah, 2 years after falling at the conference championship, and they are there. You know what? We're going to play this. We've been waiting for that to come around, and it didn't come around when we played through the first season. It's another season that Romo's won. Hello? I definitely have one. Right, fair enough. Tony Romo's too good, and they're saying he can't be upgraded anymore. But, yes, we are going to play the Super Bowl in 2022. Okay. No more years of hurt for the Cowboys. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Can we get the win 2 years after we wanted to get the win? You know what we're doing. It's going to be Ezekiel Elliott to run the ball first off. What can he do? Picks up five. It's a slightly different look team to what I've been used to. Obviously with Austin Hooper the main tight end now. Chiaverini being the backup. And of course Keelan Cole being the second receiver as well now. Right, we're going to look to hit Cole underneath as well. And there he is. Whoa, gets smacked hard. There's Michael Thomas over the middle. And he goes down into the 30. Down to the 30 of the Jacksonville Jaguars. So we'll give it to Elliott. See what happens. Oh, it's a good run. Okay, we're going to give it back to Elliott. And he goes up the middle for another 11 yards there. It's been years since they've used this play in the red zone, but it's that play. And there's Michael Thomas. Fumbles the ball, but Austin Hooper is there to collect it. Ooh, looks like the defender died as well. So, can we get the touchdown here? I'm going to give it to Elliott. They're not in a full goal line formation. And Elliott can't get there again. Okay, we're inside the 1 yard line. You know what's coming. It was so common in the 2019 season. And Romo sneaks into the end zone for a touchdown. So Romo's first drive in a Super Bowl finished with 7 points. Can we get more points now on the second drive? We're going to give it to Elliott to start, but let's see what we can do. Great run. 11 yards. It's another good run. We'll take 3 yards there. He's had 2 10-plus yard carries and a few short ones. We'll still do. Okay, we go to slants. And it's a blitz. There's Thomas. Gets tackled, but we'll get a first. So, we're going to go to the Texas play. I say it's going to be two new players that we're throwing to with this play, because Tommy Bohannon is the fullback, former Jacksonville Jaguar, so has the chance to get one over his old team. And of course, Austin Hooper is taking up the Greg Olsen role that we were so used to throwing. And there it is. He makes the catch. Okay, we'll go back to Elliott. Somehow bounces it around the outside and still gets another 7 yards there. Why stop there? We're going to give it back to Elliott and see if we can pick up this first down. Oh, we can't. He's taken down well by the safety there. Okay. Slants. It's Hearns who gets the ball. And we're inside the 5 yard line. Okay. Slants on the goal line. Who are we going to hit? No one. Okay, we're going to make it look like a run play. Let's hopefully throw the slant. There's Hooper with a catch, but he's down at the one. I was surprised that got in there. Okay, we're going to go play action waggle and hope that Hooper gets open. Usually. There's Hooper. Touchdown. And that's Tony Romo's first Super Bowl touchdown. So Jacksonville answer with a touchdown of their own. And that makes it 14-10. We'll hand the ball off to Elliott to start. And that's a Great pancake block. Elliot gets 10 there. Okay. Play action crosses. We don't use it often. But with Romo being so good at play action, we might as well make use of it. And Keelan Cole is open. He's down to the 28-yard line. Okay. So we're not in the red zone, but it's that play again. And we're going to hit Michael Thomas for another 8 yards. Okay. We're going to look to hit. Well, we're going to get two. It's not a good run, but we're going to go hurry up and hopefully get the first down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're up against a third and okay. situation. I'm going to give it to Elliott, and he's going to get the first down and more. Almost gets into the end zone. Okay. Slants, and we're going to hopefully hit Hearns. Oh. We're going to throw the ball away. Just get it away, and we're going to kick a field goal to end this second quarter. Okay, to start the second half, we're going to give it back to Elliott. And he gets another big hole up the middle. 9 yards. Don't often run outside runs, but that would be the reason, because Elliott doesn't have any awareness, apparently. Hopefully, Thomas will come open on it. And Thomas gets up to the halfway line. It's a good catch. And while we're at it, we're going to throw a Texas play in there as well. That's Austin Hooper. He's incomplete. Drops the pass on the hit, but it was there. Okay, we're going to go inside zone with Elliott. Gets another great carry. 6 yards there. Okay. To make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy. Slants, we're going to hope that one of them comes open. Now Romo. One of them should come open. I'm going to give it to Thomas. It's a good catch. Okay, it's going to be Milburn in for a rush, and it's a good run. So we're going to go play action boot. See whether we can get one of the tight ends open. We're in fact going to... Oh, no! Forcing the ball to oh no, it's 17 all now. Give it to Elliott and hope that he can pick up some good yardage, and he does. Another 11, 10 even. Going to give the ball back to Elliott. Get him another first down. It's a good run as well. Gets up to the 41. Okay, we're back to the Texas play. And got to run away and throw the ball away as well, because that was covered very well by Jacksonville there. And there's Thomas open. Miles Jack smacks him, but it's another big catch from him. Okay, we'll go to slants, and we want to hit one of the two guys from the left, and we do. Alan Hearns. Having a good game, apart from the pick. Elliott has another handoff, and he seems to be making better decisions now. Like I said before, he seems to go through phases of having real terrible decisions, but he's doing all right, this one. Okay. It's that play. We'll hit Thomas. And he gets down inside the 10 to the 7. There's Thomas with the touchdown. Well, we take the lead again, 23 to 17, with the extra point to come. Okay, with 5.5 minutes to go, we get the ball back. It's 24 to 20. We can just grind out some clock. We should be okay. So another great run from Elliott there. It's another great run from Elliott. Gets another 6. There's Elliott breaking free and he gets out of bounds at the 35. Wow, I thought that was going up. That was an unbelievable run. That's the best run I've seen Elliott have. It's a decent run, 3 yards. Two more plays and we'll be down to the 2 minute warning. So fingers crossed we can get ourselves at least a field goal. Put ourselves 7 points ahead. Elliott with another first down run. He's been unstoppable. Oh. Formation. But Michael Thomas is open anyway. Stiff arms Jalen Ramsey to the floor. If we score here, then it should guarantee us the Super Bowl.
So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown.
There's Michael Thomas, catches the ball, and that's a touchdown. 30-20 we lead, 31 with the extra point. The Jacksonville Jaguars get a touchdown, get the two-point conversion, but can't convert the onside kick, and so we will kneel out the game to win Tony Romo's first Super Bowl. It's going to be a day he's always imagined. Why have they taken the timeout? They're not going to be able to get another chance. This will win Tony Romo his first Super Bowl, and I'm ecstatic. We finally did it after the disappointment of the 2019 season. 2021-2022 season is the Cowboys. No more years of hurt. That's what we love. You love to see it. You love to see it. They even won it in their home stadium. Unbelievable. Jason Garrett, after all his faults, he's led the team to another win. And another Super Bowl win. Their first since 95, so a long old time. Oh. Tony Romo, Super Bowl MVP as well. You love to see it. And I'm so happy that he's got a Super Bowl. This might be my own incarnation of Tony Romo, but it's officially done. Fuck off, Garrett. You cost us a chance at a Super Bowl in 2019, but those other four guys deserve it. Elliott, Thomas, Keekley, and Romo. The power four. Ah. Unbelievable. Okay, so we are at the end of the 2022 season, and well, the Cowboys aren't in the wild card playoff round, so let's see if they made the playoffs. From the looks of things, they are 15-1 again. The Cowboys are unbelievable. Let's have a quick look at the stats. Well, Romo apparently was 30th in the NFL in passing yards. I mean, this is weird. Like another 34 passing touchdowns, another 5 interceptions. So decent year. He seems to go from one year to the next, either throwing very few yards to then throwing quite a lot more. Rushing though, Elliott, another 2,000 yard season. This guy is unstoppable. 11 rushing touchdowns. Mad. And again, this year, no one over 1,000 yards receiving. Most yards again is Michael Thomas, but most receptions is Keelan Cole. So decent. And Allen Hurns got 13 receiving touchdowns this year. Unbelievable. If we go to the yearly awards, Ezekiel Elliott, MVP. Tony Romo, 8th in the MVP running. We are going to advance to the Super Bowl. Okay, the Cowboys didn't make the Super Bowl. the Rams and Jags is going to be the Super Bowl matchup. We are going to have to see what happened in the playoffs. Dallas beat the Saints in the divisional playoffs, and then the Rams beat the Cowboys 28-14 in the NFC Championship game. So yet again, the Cowboys coming up one game short of the Super Bowl. Okay, so now, rather than doing season by season, we're going to skip 10 years and see whether Tony Romo makes the Hall of Fame or not. And by makes the Hall of Fame, I mean gets his legacy score up over 10,000 or 11,000, wherever it is that's needed. But he won't retire until I say for him to retire. So let's do it. Sim 10 years, let's go. Okay, it has been an emotional journey. Tony Romo potentially could be retiring. Okay, first of all, let's have a look at the legacy leaderboard. So, oh my word. So we're looking here at Tony Romo's legacy. He's a Hall of Famer, officially a Hall of Famer. Two Super Bowl wins, three AFC Championship wins, sorry, NFC Championship wins, and 11 yearly awards. We have officially been inducted into the Hall of Fame. We're going to retire Tony Romo. I mean, he's a 92 overall quarterback still. 43rd best player all time, apparently. Nice. Still won't show me his damn stats though. So retire from the league. Tony Romo's career is officially over and he'll go into the broadcast booth. Okay, well that is going to be it for Undrafted to MVP. It's officially the end. No more. Tony Romo got MVP. He got a Super Bowl. Well, he got two Super Bowls. And well, he got into the Hall of Fame and that's all I could hope for. So as always guys, thank you for watching. If you have any feedback for me, please leave it in a comment below. And if you want to keep up to date with everything I'm doing, including more Madden 19 gameplay, then please subscribe and I will see you next time. Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself. Standing in the Hall of Fame. Yeah. And the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile, you could be the hero.